What's up, everybody? We are Offended and Unfriended Reacts. We're doing a music video that none of us have watched.
Nope.
Yeah. Tom Macdonald, No Lives Matter. I was just scrolling and I saw this like. Do you guys know Tom Macdonald? Have you seen?
I could have sworn he was like an old '70s like pop singer, but you know, whatever. He's got the name of one.
I thought he was a country singer. Yeah, me too.
That picture right there is.
He's been like a controversial rapper throughout the last.
No, you definitely have
three,
a song
4 years. Yeah, you guys have definitely seen.
I've seen a video.
Virals, yeah. Like, you know, if not. I haven't seen this yet either. It was just released a few days ago.
I love the outfit.
Yeah, yo, like this whole thing
Gucci,
right here, I can just imagine.
Gucci man.
I don't really know how I feel about him as an artist yet. I don't know enough about him, so, but let's fucking give it a chance.
I'm always down for some controversy. Let's go.
Let's do it.
Hip-hop diet is full of guys who cannot even rap. Facts. Media dividing us by colors, white or black. Facts. If you believe in Jesus, these days Christians get attacked. Facts. If you don't hate police, then everybody thinks you're whack. And everything's so connected. Black Lives Matter got so aggressive. White folks who agree can't support the message. Both sides go to war because they don't respect it. Our social climate from the global tension turned to total violence and a whole depression. We could unify and then I'll go against them. But we let them divide us with votes and elections. Hey, the music we bump. All about shooting guns and doing drugs. Hey, whoa. The things that we want are promoted subliminally through the songs. Like, you need a fast car. You need designer clothes. You need a rap star to tell you to start popping pills, hit the blunt, and go live at the club till you're broke. It's all controlled by the elites. Put fake news all over our screens. Convincing the right to go fight with the left and distract from the fact it's each other we need. Divided by race and religion. Segregated into teams. You a white supremacist. If you're not, I guess you Antifa. Screaming from the rooftops, beat down better. Turn us on each other now, no lives matter. If we do what the news wants, blood gon' splatter. Turn us on each other till no lives matter. Freedom's dead if you have an opinion, take it back. Facts. People hate the president, if you don't then you trash. Facts. Indoctrinate the nation using news and mainstream rap. Facts. The government abuses us, it's all part of the plan. Facts. And it's so confusing, Black Lives Matter's a valuable movement. But all lives matter ain't racist or stupid, it's non-black humans who don't feel included. All colors fall under laws that govern the whole country and we all suffer. We're all broke and nobody recovers until we accept that we're all brothers. Hey, the music we make, all about big booties and getting paid. Hey, whoa. We watch the news and it fills up our brains with violence and riots and race. Like, this is a race war. You need to hate more. Get what you came for. You need some songs about Xanax and violence so you can escape more. What a vicious cycle we can't break away from. They control the culture, they control the paper. They're indoctrinating a whole generation till the patriots start to hate the nation. The music we love make us dumb and addicted. The news that we watch is brainwashing the children. The viruses, riots, and racist conditions ain't problems, they're symptoms of life in the system. Ooh. Screaming from the rooftops, beat down better. On each other now, no lives matter. If we do what the news wants, blood gon' splatter. Turn us on each other till no lives matter. The music will make you dumb, the media makes you hate, and they control them both. There ain't no escape. They put the world in a state of chaos. Economy crashing and massive layoffs. Black against white, or it's left versus right. Divide and conquer and control is the payoff. Screaming from the rooftops, beat down better. Turn us on each other now, no lives matter. If we do what the news wants, blood gon' splatter. Turn us on each other till no lives matter.
Rockefeller.
Okay.
Stop.
Nah, that was dope. I give him that.
Yeah, I wasn't feeling the hook that much. But
yeah.
Musically,
no, he's
lyrically, it was... I mean,
No, the hook was the hook. He okay. He gave it to you like in three levels. So you got the bars, but then he gave you the catchiness. Because if you if you're young, you leave with the news will make you splatter. Blood's gonna splatter.
Right.
Yeah, it was more of just like the melody he used. It was had nothing to do with anything. This was the producer side of me going. I think you could have found a better melody, but something a little catchier. But
no, I think he went for the dumb. I think he really dumbed down.
I think he does that.
No, it's fine.
It's he's as dumb as I can say it.
Yeah. I would listen to the song again just because of the lyrics. That's one of those songs where the beat's great. The beat's fucking great. Mm-hmm. Just the verse, the way the low end. We heard that on computer speakers, low end. Yeah. That's called fantastic mixing, people.
Yeah, no, great mixing for sure. I'll be honest, what I take from it, the video itself was sick.
Video was
like,
cool.
I like the way that was shot and edited. Yeah, you know, like that was really cool, and it was kind of jestful in there.
Now we're looking at it as artists, so
yeah.
But lyrically, I mean, it definitely wasn't controversial. Yeah, right. I think the headline of it is controversial. No lives matter, but the way I like
the message though. The way he used the words. Theme there, yeah.
They're making you feel like no lives matter, but the way he said it, it's like, oh, what is he saying?
Yeah,
like,
exactly. But it's clickbait. So it's great though.
It is, and you get a lot of good messages within it. You get a lot of real.
I don't love the song. Like you, I don't love the beat.
The beat was alright.
It slams, you know. Yeah, yeah, definitely.
I love low ends.
No, he rapped well on it too.
His lyrics are good, you know. Definitely.
I give him that.
I like what he was. I like what he's saying. I like how he sprinkled in, you know, the music industry as well, because like a lot of people,
it's facts. Yeah,
you know, like when you talk politics, like they don't even think of entertainment as a form of, or at least like a branch of, and you know, it's.
But he called out music the way hip hop, what they talk about, and what's big, but. But
talking about guns, drugs, and
but it's been like that since.
Booties,
and get back in the club and spend your money.
How long has it been like that for, though? Realistically,
but these newer kids, like it's not like it used to be, where like you know Snoop Dogg when we were growing up had like gin and juice, and you know it was.
But they got that sprinkled
in. No, you got
in.
Like these little kids. You got these new rappers, you know, where they're talking about like you know go steal your mom's Xanax,
right?
And
it's
you
more
know,
drug
addict. Drinking, it's drug. Oh, yeah.
They weren't glorifying being powerful with money, and they glorify
being a scummy, sneaky druggie.
There's a meme that you'll see all the time. It's like my generation was the drug dealers. This generation is the drug users. Like,
I didn't hear that one.
That's what it's like. Yeah,
these kids today, they never heard of don't get high on your own supply. Right? You know what I mean?
Yeah, they don't get that.
They get high on their own supply just
all the time.
They go, Mom, can you buy me some more? You know?
Or they get high on their own supply. They sell just enough to.
To buy more.
Yeah.
Right.
So basically, they're just doing
feeding
it for
their
free.
Own addiction.
They're doing it for free. Yeah, they're feeding their own addiction.
Yeah. But yo, hats off to Tom Macdonald for that one. You know, I like it.
I honestly thought it was going to be controversial. I feel like I was wrong. I feel like it's a very positive message in there.
Sure.
It's hard to disagree with it from either side. Like, how can anyone listen to that and go, that's bullshit? Like, nah, he makes sense.
Yeah. No, agreed.
He makes sense when it comes to everything. He attacked both sides, both races, all race. Like, he attacked everything. Media, music. He hit every point.
Definitely his least controversial of the songs that I know of his. And
he has things that are really more controversial?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, wow. I mean, that's why I knew him. That's why he popped up in the recommendeds.
And that's also probably why he called it that, to kind
you
of be,
clicked
you know.
The recommended?
Are you nuts?
I did. Well,
no, I'm fucking around.
I did it. It popped up in my recommended.
Yeah,
I was like,
didn't you watch The Social Dilemma? You don't do that.
I didn't watch
it. Type it in.
I didn't click it on the recommended. I saved it for watching with you guys, and I typed it in here. So I didn't click the recommended. Yeah, I'm still
on that. Thank you for watching. If we come up in the recommended, though, you could hit it. Please,
recommend us to your friends.
Word of mouth is always the best.
Don't spy on them after you recommend it. That's the only difference.
I know. Make sure they liked and subscribed.
Subscribe and like.
Yeah.
Or just send Offended and Unfriended some message.
It's a JP.
Let us know.
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody. Offended and Unfriended reacts. Come back again.
Yeah. Go see the podcast.